And joining us now is Buhay Partylist Representative Lito Atienza. Congressman, good afternoon and thank you so much for joining us.
Magandang hapon sa inyo. Mabuhay.
Mabuhay, sir. So, what's your assessment on the hearing of alleged bias of ABS-CBN?
Kung meron bias, I would accuse my colleagues. Sila ang biased. They go in there with a set frame of mind and you would notice by their reasoning, talagang papunta sila sa patunayan yung kanilang hinala na wala naman silang preba. Kaya paulit-ulit lang ang tanong, paikot-ikot ang procedure, not getting anywhere. Meanwhile, they accuse ABS of bullying. Sino nagbubully? Tingnan nga ninyo, who's bullying who? I accuse my colleagues, many of them, four of them at least, naging lima sila kasama si Garin kagabi at bullying. Sila ang bully. I merely corrected the direction that we were taking. Anong sinabi ng chair? Are you arguing with me? with the menacing, no? Are you arguing with the chair? No, what I'm saying is that we have to redirect the discussions here. This is all about the ABS franchise application. Mm-hmm. Eh, kung saan napupunta ang usapan, napunta na kami sa Dengbox siya. Mm-hmm. They allowed former Secretary Garin all the time. I think it's almost 1.5 hours that she used up while we were waiting. Kami, pinaghihintay kami nakahanda tungkol dun sa franchise application. She was defending herself from the mess.
Congressman, as a franchise issue, what should it be focusing on?
Well, on the accusation. There are accusations. But there are also resource persons that we've invited who should be given the time to explain. Like what I did. Sabi nila, meron daw violations ng ABS. So tinanong ko yung KBP. Alam ko kasi na ang mga batas kaya talagang inaalaw ang media to police themselves. And that's the reason why the KBP has been organized. Pisana ng broadcasters ng Pilipinas. Meron ba kayong record of ABS abusing its power in a biased manner? Wala po. Meron ba kayong reklamong natatanggap? Meron po. If I remember correctly, sabi ng presidente ng KBP, 2013, mind you, that's 7 years ago. Mm-hmm. Merong mga 11 complaints, which we acted on. Naayos naman niya namin between the two parties, ABS and the complainant. Mm-hmm. In other words, sabi ko, would you consider ABS as a recidivist perennial violators of rights and fair play? I mean, no. I cannot accuse ABS of that. ABS has always been one of the most responsible networks, a member of the KBP. Para sa akin, yan ang dapat ang hearing na aming dinidinig. Makinig kami. Hindi yung mag-accuse kami.
Right.
At saka unapunan nyo, from the very beginning, yung accusation, madalas, walang dokumento, walang proof. Hihingan pa ang ABS, produce these documents. 25 years ago, 30 years ago. Lalo na si Congressman Marculeta, ganun siya magtanong. Meron siya accusation, sabihin niya sa ABS, you produce the documents of 1988.
Right.
It's not fair. We are not hearing the validity of the franchise. Mm-mm. We're not considering real public service, public welfare, national interest. Let's face it, the issue of the ABS franchise is already of national interest, welfare, public service.
This issue of political bias, Congressman, or questionable reporting by ABS-CBN, it was raised by several lawmakers. And despite the COMELEC and kapisanan ng mga broadcaster ng Pilipinas saying there are no cases of bias against the network, should these have been raised at the franchise hearing? Shouldn't formal complaints have been filed before the appropriate organizations to address them?
You know, in a hearing, you can really ask anything. That's fine with me. But having been clarified by authoritative sources, I think we should stop at that and accept it. That's part of the hearing process. We should listen. Hindi yung you're out to prove that the ABS is guilty to the point of literally going on a fishing expedition. You look for evidences along the way, but you have already alleged very serious violations, like the constitutional issues raised against ABS. Say, isa naman ang sagot yan. Para sa akin, malinaw yun. Yung citizenship, yung PDRs, yung length of the franchise not to be not more than 50, yeah, dun maling-mali sila. They were accusing the ABS of violating the Constitution because more than 50 years na rin yung operations ng ABS.
Congressman, do franchise hearings typically deal with content and, in this case, alleged bias? In previous franchise hearings that you've sat through, perhaps, and would these be actual qualifications or credentials to not grant a franchise?
Well, I am afraid the ones who are very vocal are the ones who will really go against and vote against. But I am also confident that many of my colleagues who are just merely listening, and they are also, I'm sure, forming an opinion of positive reactions. Alam naman nila yung ginagawa ng mga kasama namin eh. We're all experienced, except for the new ones, no? We're experienced members of Congress, parliamentarians. We have held committee hearings. I'm telling you, Raim, this is the only hearing that I have attended and participated in from my years in the Batas ng Pambansa, and then from 2013, my three terms now, this is my third term as congressman. This is the only hearing I've attended and participated in which has taken this long and so divisive and so controversial, to say the least. Mm-hmm. Dahil yung mga nagtatanong, hindi nagtatanong, umuusig. Iba yun eh. Iba yung nagpo-prosecute ka, parang ginawa nilang parang trial ito. Public trial for ABS. And to me, it's not fair. Pag yung accusation mo nasagot na, kung talagang tayo ay hindi biased, tama na yun. Pero for you to even go around again and around and around and trying to look for a slip-up in the statements of the resource person, from the ABS officer, obviously, you're just wishing. Pati ba naman yung mga dates? You expect people to remember what happened in 1978, 1992, 1987, the dates, March 16. Eh, masyadong mga detalyado na may hinahanap sila hanggang hindi nila nakikita at hindi nila na papatunayan yung kanilang allegation, parang hindi tumitigil. So they're prosecuting already rather than listening.
Congressman, the complaint of Cavite Representative Remulla, which he asked to be taken up by the Blue Ribbon or Ways and Means Committee on Cyberbullying, and for which he sought an NBI investigation, would this be part of or separate from the franchise hearings?
To me, it should be separate. If they would want to further, if the intention is just to delay further the decision, well, they will try to connect it. But it should be separate because it is purely a different issue. If ABS is found guilty of cyberbullying, that's a criminal offense. Yun dapat i-demanda nila, tama yun. At tapos, hindi yung mag-hearing pa, i-demanda na ng supposed victim of the bullying and proving his allegations in court so that they can ask this kind of question.
So
because
who...
Because nila yan sa deliberations namin ngayon sa franchisa, lalong magkaka-delay itong ating decision.
Right. So who, Congressman, who or how would they deliberate on whether that cyberbullying accusation, allegation should be discussed as part of the franchise hearing?
The leadership of Congress. Hmm. If Speaker Ala Cayetano is sincere in what he is pronouncing publicly, then he should pull in the guys and say, "Idemanda ninyo, pero itong hearing natin, makukulun nito with the decision. Do we approve or we do not approve?"
Understood.
Hindi yung iikot na naman tayo on another issue that would delay it unnecessarily. Remember, these are not normal times, right?
Mm-hmm.
People are jobless. People are getting hungry. People are all afraid to get sick. So merong fear factor, tapos yung ekonomiya natin talagang nakadapa na. So para sa akin, the decision on the ABS issue should consider all of this.
Mm-hmm. Do you think, Congressman?
Will it be good for the country for a giant company like ABS be closed down? Is it going to be good for the nation, for millions of people who are locked down, staying at home by force, and then na-entertain lang siya ng kanyang kapirasyong black box, inalis pa sa kanya, at kung permanently mawala yan, ano sasabihin natin sa bayan? Kami ang gobyerno, kami makapangyarihan, we talk about power here. Doon ako medyo nagagalit. Whenever I hear the word power, I'm not cowed, I'm not coerced, I get angry. Yan eh, reaction ko kay Defensor, kay Remulla. I often hear them about power.
Well, definitely, Congressman, there was an accusation about abusing the privilege of being the fourth estate, and unemployment definitely a primordial concern right now. But do you think ABS-CBN was able to effectively state its case enough to address the concerns of lawmakers in ABS-CBN's reporting, ownership, tax payments, block time agreement, PDR issuance, and even labor?
Well, Frame, I have been observing Philippine media all these years. I've been an active member of the advertising industry in the past, before I entered politics. So, lahat itong mga issue ito, alam ko. So, I cannot call ABS a perfect corporation. It is a big network, a big corporation, but knowing the history that ABS had to go through, remember, kinuha ni Marcos yung network na yan. Tapos naisol yun nung nagkaroon tayo ng revolusyon. Tapos even that was being questioned by some members. Bakit nakuha ng mga Lopez? Eh, paano kanila yun? Sabi ko nga, example ko dyan, may bahay ka, nag-martial law. Kinuha nung kapitbahay mo, military officer yung bahay mo, mahal na mahal mo. And nanalo ang revolusyon. Kinuha mo yung bahay mo ulit. Sama ba yun o mali ba yun o ano? Kailangan, bakit daw hindi nagbayad? Babayaran mo yung bahay mo? Eh sa'yo yun? Yung mga Lopez ang may-ari niyan eh. I may not like everything that ABS has represented in the past, but I cannot question the ownership in that manner. At saka yung mga constitutional issues nila. Sinabi ng Filipino-American yung si Gabby Lopez. Tanggapin na natin, tanungin na lang natin, is it legal or illegal to be owning or running a Philippine media corporation if you are both? Eh, wala naman nagsasabing batas na illegal. So it has to be considered legal.
Mm-hmm.
And ganun din lahat yung mga accusation. So therefore, I really feel we have wasted so much time, money, and effort, time of Congress. Instead of pinag-uusapan namin ngayon yung mga how to address the problem of poverty, economic depression, and pinag-uusapan natin franchise, which will further aggravate the economic condition.
Right. Well,
and deprive people of their joys, simple joys. Sa akin, ill-timed.
Congressman Atienza,
So we look at it that way.
Looking at Thursday now, what do you think we should expect at the summation, and how do you expect the House committees to vote?
Sabi ni Speaker Cayetano, I heard it from ANC this morning, that he will allow a conscience vote. I hope he delivers that commitment. If it's a conscience vote, ABS wins. Mm-hmm. If it's a forced vote, dictated vote, ABS is sure to lose. Yun po naman ang aking simpleng pananaw.
Hoping for the best here. Buhay Partylist Representative Lito Atienza, thank you so much for your sharing your assessment and insight, Congressman. We appreciate it.
Thank you for the opportunity.
And stay safe, sir.